Deputy Police Chief Thomas Kirik, again, with Chair Phil Dawson, and assisting will be CJ Inland Directors Ian Miller, Morris Cassie, and Agnes Lee, to present the retired Chief of York Region Police Amar Lavage Coin Award.
This medal is given to members that have strived and competed in St. John Ambrose competition during the past year. We have two cadet division and two adult division to receive this award. The first group of this award is from Rally 1278, Richmond Hill Cadet Division. They have 12 members to receive the cause. They are Tiffany Ren, Terry Stowe, Jeffrey Chang, James Brown, Gabriel Chen, Justin Cho, Marcus Tan. Next group to receive the card is from York Central, Medical First Responder Unit 548. They have 8 members to receive the cards. Please come forward.
Our last group to receive the coins is from Unit 975, Mark and Unionville Medical First Responders. They have 7 members to receive the coins. Please come forward.
Congratulations, Honorary members. Your next goes to Eleanor McConnell from North Road 29 and Angela Welcome Wackies from North 910. Eleanor is to receive the 12-year service medal while Angela is to receive the 27th service bond.
Before we get started, I'm going to turn around and speak to the audience, but don't take any slight by that. To our many dignitaries here tonight, whether they come from the political world, we have our members of Parliament who support us with St. John Day and some special recognition within the legislature every year, the mayors of our community here, or our police services. We even dragged a deputy commissioner from Toronto EMS up here because we wanted to see how it's done in one of the more organized regions for us. So if you have any comments or Rick, feel free to pass along. I have to tell all the people on parade that today was an excellent parade. You may guess that this is not my first parade, but it is the first parade for an awful lot of people on the floor today. And I can tell you from all the inspecting party officers and members that you've done an excellent job. I'm going to turn around for a minute so you can just listen to me intently. To all the parents and the grandparents and the supporters and the friends and the family members who've lost, no doubt one or two dinners where people were away doing community service duties, helping in the community on a regular basis, and doing wonderful work. I want you to know that we very much appreciate the support that you get on a regular basis to make it workable for all of our volunteers to take part. Whether it's driving them out to the parade on a night or just supporting them when they get home. Because I can tell all the parents of all of our youth members tonight, they've been working very hard since about 9 o'clock this morning. So I don't think they'll be looking for any extra screen time when they get home. They may be asleep by 8:30. So I should be finished my speech by then. So to all the people on parade, your region branch is the strongest branch in Ontario and probably in Canada. We have hundreds of 30-odd volunteers across every community, the 9 communities that make up your region. We have clearly one of the strongest youth groups anywhere in your region when you consider all the young people who have taken part here today. And our medical first responders, the group that the people in the behind me see on the left, that represents almost 100 medical first responders who've completed 40 hours of preparatory training so that they can be ready in the event of an emergency or crisis in our region. Over and above our adult medical first responders, our senior youth members have qualified for that level as well. So to our mayor and to the provincial member, you can sleep well tonight knowing that there are people ready should a crisis occur in your region, as it did with SARS, as it did with the ice storm, to step forward. So I ask the audience a round of applause for the 100th medical first responders.
is our crime scene technician crew. They have allowed hundreds of anxious parents to properly install car seats on any number of occasions, at different locations, and I can tell you, it's always humorous to see the anxious mom arrive, and it doesn't matter if the husband was a professional engineer and a technical expert, she would not allow the car seat to be touched until one of our technicians made sure that it explained it was properly installed. So well over 1,000 families have benefited in the last couple of years from our car seat therapy group. So for our technicians in the stands and in the audience, again, a round of applause. Thank you very much. And as we leave this parade, you are going to see the cornerstone achievement in your region, all branded, all within the last 15 years. Our therapy dog group. For those who don't know, there isn't a nursing home in the region that has asked for support that hasn't had it. We are uniquely positioned in the province of Ontario to provide support for victims of crime so that they can properly give testimony in court and are relaxed and comfortable. So when you see the representative group, if they can stand up, our therapy dog people, just to be a stand up. Although we only have four here today, they represent well over 200 volunteers in our community. So to our car seat people and our therapy officers, a round of applause. For the province, and I go back 35 years on parade. And Stu, I know that you and I would have been looking out from the square saying, when is that old white haired guy going to stop talking? And you're wondering that now. So I'm going to stop talking by saying, thanks again. This group represents St. John well. They keep our region safe. And it's been a pleasure for all those involved in today's parade to be with you. So, Raymond, carry on.
Yeah.